want to take a minute or two and just look at the evidence for glucose control in the perioperative period. We're going to give these patients insulin in the perioperative period. Why do we do so? What is the history of the research into this? Now, the history is a bit checkered. First of all, we thought it's a normal response to have an increased glucose level postoperatively. And indeed, that is so. Glucose levels do go up postoperatively, and there's physiological reasons for this. It cannot always just be left to chance, though. A patient who's diabetic cannot just be left to have their glucose be totally uncontrolled. You are going to run into cases of morbidity, even mortality, if that is so. Then research came along and looked at very tight control of glucose levels. You really try to keep it below 110 milligrams per deciliter. Now multiply by 0.0555, that gives you about 6.1 millimoles per liter. Very tight control. And big research was done, and it really showed a decrease in morbidity and mortality. Then randomized trials started coming out to show that perhaps is not really the truth, and you can actually increase morbidity and mortality by such very tight control. And why was that so? Why did this discrepancy in the research? Well, the first research really was not randomized, and it really involved putting together a very good resources and taking care of these patients. So nurses well-trained, and they really put effort into treating and monitoring those patients to keep that glucose levels very tightly controlled, as I said, below 110, but also avoiding hypoglycemia. But that doesn't work in just normal circumstances. When trials, when patients were randomized under normal settings, it was shown that there are a lot of incidences of hypoglycemia, and that is just as important. And there's actually a trend towards increased mortality, morbidity and mortality, specifically due to other factors as well, but specifically due to the episodes of hypoglycemia. So today we stand in a situation where we really just try to control the glucose. We really try to keep it below 180 milligrams per deciliter. That's about 10 millimoles per liter. As long as we can keep it below that, you will have better outcomes than either just leaving it be, which really is not on, or doing that very tight control of keeping it below 110.